If your EDLA panel has been set up, you'll likely come up to this screen, which means it's locked. That's okay, it's just the lock screen. And in order to get past it, we just have to swipe up and you'll notice that it should be set to the owner account. Now, we don't access the owner account because that's used for IT and troubleshooting. If I click this drop-down menu, you'll notice that I will see a list of any users that are already signed into the panel, so you can see I'm already signed in. I can browse as a guest, so if this is a panel I don't use a lot, I can just quickly get in there, do what I need to, and get out without it saving my information. Or if I am going to use this a lot, I can add a user, which then would let me put my account on the panel. Now, when you want to switch, you can select the name off the list. I can now swipe up. Again, I'm on the lock screen, and I can enter the PIN code that I had to create for adding my account. You'll also notice that on the lock screen, the icon at the top shows which user is currently logged in. And if I click that, there's another menu that lets me switch or go between users. So now we'll swipe up here, we'll go down, we'll add a user. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna ask me to put in a name. We're gonna call this TS1 because we're just gonna do this as a demo. Choose OK. This is going to create a new local account on the panel, and then we're going to have to go through some steps to get our Google account set up. So the first one is to choose continue. This can take a minute as it gets device information. Sometimes it's just checking for updates, even though there may not be an update available. So just be patient on this screen. Once you get here, you need to put in your email and password. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. If you ever notice that your keyboard's not popping up, sometimes it's just hidden over here on the left. Choose the keyboard icon and then it will pop up for you. Now, once you've typed in your email password, you just gotta agree to the Google terms. Next, we gotta approve Google services such as location and updates. Choose accept. And then you gotta enter a PIN code. This is just a way to make sure that your account is secure. So I can do screen lock options if I want to. You can choose different ways to lock it. We recommend a PIN code. I'm just gonna type in 1234. Don't make that your PIN code. That's just for this training and for demo, but it is something you need to remember. It needs to be at least 4 digits, but it can be more than 4 digits if you would like to make it that. So I'm gonna choose next, and then I just gotta enter it one more time. Confirm. On this screen, it's gonna ask you if you wanna turn on Google Assistant. We recommend not, you don't want Google popping up when you're using your screen. So we're gonna skip these 2 steps, and then we're gonna say no thanks in terms of adding additional accounts. And now your account is set up and ready to go. Now, when you're logged into your account, there's a couple ways to log out. The first way is just to turn off the panel. Anytime you turn it off, it logs everything out. However, if you just swipe down from the middle or from the top, this opens up your settings and you'll see the account button is down here. Right now it says T because I'm logged in as Trade Show 1, and so that T is showing up first. That's my account, or the TS1. When I select that, you'll notice now I could switch. So if I'm this account, I can now jump over to my other account. And when I press that, you'll see that it's switching. It's going to take me to the lock screen. I can swipe up, and now I can enter the PIN code for that account. So the panel can have lots of accounts installed on it. This is how you add an account, and also how you can switch back and forth. Or if you're just using it for a temporary amount of time, you can use guest mode.